Hi, it's Panda Movies here. Today I'm going to explain the movie called Brainstorm. Warning, there are spoilers ahead. Enjoy the video. Scientists develop a brain-computer interface that allows sensations from a person's brain to be captured and transferred to tape for others to experience. Michael and Karen, their estranged husband and wife, as well as Michael's coworker Lillian, make up the team. The crew follows CEO Alex's instructions and shows the device to investors in order to secure funding. While working with Michael and Lillian, Karen dons the recorder. The group realizes that emotional events are also recorded when Michael plays the tape again. Michael records his memories of Karen and shares them with her, resulting in their reunion. Backers pressurize Lillian to accept Landon, whom she views as a member of the military-industrial complex. She opposes their desire to develop the innovation for military use. Gordy, one of the team members, engages in sexual activity while wearing the recorder and distributes the tape with his co-workers, including Hal. Hal splices one segment of the tape into a continuous orgasm, causing sensory overload and forcing him to retire. As the potential for abuse becomes obvious, tensions rise. Lillian, who has heart difficulties and is a cigarette smoker, has a heart attack while working alone. Lillian records her experience when she realizes she is about to die. Later, Michael decides to listen to Lillian's recording, but his body simulates a heart attack, and he nearly dies. Michael makes a change to his console to filter the physical output, and then replays the tape. He sees memory bubbles, which he describes as moments from Lillian's life. Lillian recalls a funny discussion with Michael when he plays with an industrial robot, a surprise birthday celebration, and being devastated when Alex informs her that an earlier project has been canceled. As Michael plays Lillian's recording, scientists interested in learning more about the machine's military capabilities keep an eye on it. They have Gordy watch the film, but Landon dismisses the monitoring staff's advice that Michael had made changes to his terminal. Gordy passes away as a result of Lillian's heart attack. Hal cuts Michael's replay short, but Michael is curious to see the complete tape after seeing the near-death experience. Alex has the recording secured and informs Michael that he will not be able to access it. When Michael returns to work, he finds Landon and other outside techs combing over his study files. As a result of his protests, Alex fires Michael and Karen. Michael tries to gain access to the lab's computers. Hal recommends that he investigate into Project Brainstorm, a military program designed to leverage their innovation for torture and indoctrination. Michael retrieves a tape from his den and promptly abandons it due to its unpleasant content. Inadvertently seeing the tape by Michael and Karen's son Chris causes him to have a psychotic experience, resulting in his hospitalization. When Alex comes to visit, Michael confronts him about Project Brainstorm, accusing him of being responsible for his son's illness. Alex denies knowing anything about the project until informing Michael of Gordy's death. Michael intends to destroy his work and enlists Karen and Hal's assistance. Michael and Karen arrive at the Pinehurst Resort and stage a fight after realizing they are being watched. Karen then flees to Hal's residence. Michael enters the Brainstorm computer via another phone line, while Karen hacks into the system, damaging the robots that create the interface terminals, as the two simulate reconciliation over the phone. Karen turns off the security system, locking the employees outdoors and allowing Michael to load and watch Lillian's tape uninterrupted. With the plant in disarray, Robert issues an arrest warrant for Michael. Karen goes out of the house to meet Michael. Karen's last directives are sent to the firm computers by Hal and his wife Wendy, and the systems are shut down. While the tape is playing, Karen meets with Michael. Even after the recording finishes, Michael bears witness to the afterlife, seeing a vision of hell before moving away from Earth and through the universe. He sees angels and departed souls flying into a vast cosmic light in the end. Michael then passes out. Karen tears as she believes he is dead. She begs Michael to come back to life. He weeps with joy as he awakens from the event and embraces Karen.